Consider a second order system that is shown over here. Here is the feedback, unity feedback. The system is of second order that you can observe over here. S square plus 2 zeta omega ns is there in the denominator. If we find out the equivalent transfer function for this closed loop, that can be written like that. Omega n square by s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square. So this is our transfer function for the second order system. So C of s, that's the output, can be written as R of s into G of s, where G of s is the transfer function of the system. So output in S domain can be expressed like this. We are evaluating the step response, unit step response. So our R of s is equal to 1 by s. So C of s will be equal to 1 by s into G of s, that is this one. And we are doing this for the critically damped system where zeta is equal to 1. So now taking this equation, that's the output equation, output response of the system, and considering zeta is equal to 1, this can be written like this. That is the output response in frequency domain. Now this term can be written like that, s plus omega n square, this one. Now we need to make the partial fractions of this one. So this portion can be written like that, a over s, that is this pole, then b over s plus omega n, and c over s plus omega n square. We have repeated poles. Okay, so this is our main equation, and we want to simplify this one, and we want to evaluate a, b and c so that we can express this one in terms of simple fractions. So from this equation, I can write down this one, and then collecting, expanding this term, I can write it like this. Now let's suppose that s is equal to 0, considering this term. So if s is equal to 0, these terms will become 0, and a into omega n square will be equal to omega n square. So we can say a is equal to 1. So we will use a is equal to 1 in this expression. Now comparing the s square terms in this equation a, on this side there is no term with s square, but over here a is with s square and b is with s square. So a plus b is equal to 0. So from here we can find out the value of b by using the value of a in this expression. Similarly, now comparing the s terms of this equation a, 0s over here, over here with the s is 2 omega n into a, and over here with the s is omega n into b, and over here is c. So 2 omega n a plus b omega n plus c, that is equal to 0. So using the value of a and b, we can find out the value of c, that will be equal to minus omega n. So this equation, that is equation m, now can be written like this. We have calculated a, b and c. So now taking the Laplace inverse of this equation, we will get this one, taking Laplace inverse on both sides of this equation. So we will get this one, and the Laplace inverse of this one is 1, the Laplace inverse of this one e raised power minus omega n t, and the Laplace inverse of this portion is omega n t into e raised power minus omega n t. So this is the time domain equation for the step response of the second order system, which is in which the zeta is equal to 1, that is, it is the critically damped system. So now if I sketch this equation, that is C of t is on this axis and time is on this axis, so you will get this response. So this is the response of the second order critically damped system where zeta is equal to 1. There are no oscillations in this one. The system is going to attain the desired output, that is 1, because we have applied the unit step input slowly and gradually. So this is the response of the second order critically damped system. Let us evaluate the step response of undamped second order system. The undamped second order system is the one in which zeta is equal to 0. So the transfer function of the second order system is this one, where CFS is the output, RFS is the input. If the zeta is equal to 0, then this transfer function can be written like this. This term will become 0. Okay, so from this expression, we can write this one, that C of S will be equal to omega n square by S square plus omega n square into RS. We are evaluating the step response. So R of S will be equal to 1 by S. So this will be written as omega n square divided by S into S square plus omega n square, where this S is because of the step response. Okay, now we need to make the partial fractions of this one to take the inverse Laplace. So this response equation C of S, that is equal to omega n square by S into S square plus omega n square, can be written like that, that it is equal to A by S plus B S plus C divided by S square plus omega n square. Now from this equation, I can write this equation A. If I multiply this equation with S into S square plus omega n square, I can write this equation. Omega n square is equal to this one. S and S will be cancelled out, so one term will be left, and BS plus C into S. Okay, now if we consider S is equal to 0 from here, so this term will become 0, this term will become 0, this will also become 0. So A will be equal to 1, because over here we have omega n square with the A over here, so the A will come out to be 1. Now if we compare the S square terms, so with S square terms over here, there is A and S square, this one, so A plus B should be equal to 0, because on this side there is 0. So we have this equation, we know the value of A, so we can evaluate B. And if we compare S terms, so with S there is C over here and there is 0 over here, so C is 0. So after evaluating these coefficients, what we can do, we can write this equation M like this, by using the value of A, that is equal to 1, and using the value of B, that is equal to minus 1. So minus 1 S divided by S square plus omega n square. So now let's take the inverse Laplace of this one. So taking inverse Laplace on both sides and evaluating it, so this can be written as 1 minus cos of omega n t. So this is the response equation in time domain for the second order system in which the zeta is equal to 0. So now if we want to sketch that one, this is 1, so I have sketched it over here, this function is 1, and we want to subtract the cosine function from this one, so this is the cosine function. So now if I subtract this function, cosine function, from this one, so I am going to get this function. So when the zeta is equal to 0, the output will oscillate. So this graph is showing you the oscillations at the output system, at the output of your system. So we have observed the step response of an undamped second order system. Let us look at the step response of an undamped second order system. For an undamped system, the zeta is between 0 and 1. So second order system with feedback is shown over here. And if we look at its equivalent transfer function, that is a closed loop transfer function between RS and CS, that is given by this expression. So the transfer function CS over RS can be written like this. And from this equation, we can write that output C of s is equal to R of s into G of s. As we are looking for the step response, so our R of s will be equal to 1 by s. So using this equation, I can write that C of s is equal to 1 by s into the transfer function of the system. So this equation now can be used over here, and we can make the partial fractions. So this equation now can be written as A by s plus B s plus C divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. So from this equation, I can write this equation, right, after multiplying it with this denominator. Okay, so now let's compare the s square terms. So with A we have s square, and over here with B we have the s square, right, and with over here there is 0. So A plus B is equal to 0, first equation. And if we compare the s terms, so s is over here, so 2 zeta omega and A, and it is with C, so plus C, that should be equal to 0. And if we take s is equal to 0 in this equation, so this term and this term will be cancelled out, and A omega n square will be equal to omega n square, so A will be equal to 1. Once we know the value of A, we can find out the value of B using equation 1, that will be equal to minus 1. And similarly, if we know A and B, we can find out the value of C with this equation 2. So that comes out to be this one, C is equal to minus 2 zeta omega n. Now if I use the value of this A, B and C in this equation, so I can write this equation that this function, that is the response function, this output of your step response in S domain, that can be written like this. Now I can divide it into two parts. Just observe over it. Observe over here that I have separated into two parts. 2 zeta omega n can be written as zeta omega n plus zeta omega n. So 1 zeta omega n is over here, and the second zeta omega n is over here. So because of this minus, this is minus over here. So I have separated this term into two parts. What I am going to do, I am going to develop the standard function over here so that I can easily take the Laplace inverse. So now let's consider this equation, that is this one. So I can write it like that if I add this term plus zeta omega n square and subtract that as well, so there will be no difference. So now I can combine these terms and I can write it like that, s square plus zeta omega n square, and this term can be written like this. So from here, if I take omega n square, so 1 minus zeta square will be multiplied over here, and this term is the square term. Okay, so now let's suppose that this is equal to omega d square, where omega d is equal to omega n into 1 minus zeta square. So this term now can be written like this. So this term is simplified and is written in this form. So now in this equation, in equation x, we are going to replace these two terms with its equivalent. So that is the equivalent over here. So this equation x now can be written like this using this equation. Okay, now in this equation, what we are going to do, I am going to multiply and divide by 1 minus zeta square over here. So if I divide by 1 minus zeta square and multiply it with 1 minus zeta square, so omega n into 1 minus zeta square will become equal to omega d. So this is written as omega d, and rest of the equations terms are same. Now using the Laplace tables, taking the inverse Laplace, this is equal to 1. This is the cosine function but delayed, and delay is of this zeta omega n, so that will be reflected over here using the displacement theorem in S domain. Similarly over here, this is the Laplace inverse of sine of omega t into e raised power minus zeta omega n t. So from this equation, after taking the Laplace inverse, we can write down this equation. Okay, now let's simplify this one. So if I take e raised power zeta omega n t common out, so what will be left over here? Cos of omega dt and sine of omega dt into this part. Okay, so now if I divide it by 1 minus zeta square, So then I will have to multiply 1 minus zeta square inside. So this term will be multiplied with 1 minus zeta square under root. And when we multiply 1 minus zeta square over here, this will be cancelled out and we will be left with zeta only. Okay, now let's look at a triangle. Let's suppose that we have a triangle whose base is equal to z, whose height is 1 minus zeta square. So its hypotenuse will be equal to 1. So in this triangle, we can say that zeta is equal to cos of theta. Right? So let's define that zeta is equal to cos of alpha. This angle is considered as alpha. So cos square alpha plus sin square alpha is equal to 1. So from here I can look for the sin square theta, that will be equal to 1 minus zeta square, and sin alpha can be written as 1 minus zeta square. Right? So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to replace this zeta with cos of alpha, and I'm going to replace this 1 minus zeta square using this equation with sine of alpha. So this equation now can be written like that we have replaced zeta 1 minus zeta square under root with sine of alpha, and zeta is replaced with cos of alpha. Now by writing in this form, I can convert it into a single trigonometric function using the trigonometric identities. So sine of omega dt plus alpha. So this is the response equation in time domain for the step input to the second order system, which is underdamped. It means the zeta is between 0 and 1. So now let's sketch this one. If we have the sinusoidal function and if we multiply it with this exponential function, so we will get decaying sinusoidal function. Its magnitude will be decreasing. So we have this term, we have the decaying term, and this is the sinusoidal function. So when it will be multiplied with this one, right, so we will get a sort of sine wave like this. And now we are going to take its difference with 1. 1 is our desired value. So if we take its difference with 1, so the response of our second order system will be somewhat like this. So if you take different values of the time and you implement this equation, you will get this as the response for an undamped system. So you are going to observe the oscillations in the undamped system. So when you are going to apply the step input, you will observe these oscillations, and finally it becomes equal to 1 in the steady state. So there is an overshoot, the increase with respect to the desired value over here. This is said to be the overshoot in your response, right? So in the next upcoming videos, we will look for the time domain specifications. In that we will discuss about rise time, settling time, delay time, overshoot, and other parameters of the second order system. Now look at the step response of overdamped second order system. The overdamped system is the one in which the zeta is greater than 1. Okay, so this shows the closed loop second order system, and its equivalent closed loop transfer function is this one. So the transfer function of our second order system is this one, and the output response equation is this one, and we are looking for the step response. That's why RS is equal to 1 by S. So using this equation, output will be written as 1 by S into the system transfer function. We know that the poles of a second order system are evaluated with the help of this equation. So if you look for a zeta greater than 1, so this will be a real term. So the two poles will be the real poles. There is no imaginary part in this one. So that's why I can write that S plus one pole is minus zeta omega n plus, and the second pole is minus zeta omega n minus this term. So I can write these poles like that, S plus zeta omega n plus omega n into zeta square minus 1, and the second term will be with S plus zeta omega n minus omega n into zeta square minus 1, and 1 by S is this one, that is because of the step response, step input. So now we can write it in this form to make the partial fractions. And let's assume that you can make the partial fractions of this one. I'm just going to take the Laplace inverse directly. So Laplace inverse of this will be 1, and these terms will appear like that, exponentials of 1 by s plus a is equal to the Laplace inverse of this is e raised power minus a t. So using this one, you can write it like this. Some constant will be there over here. So when you evaluate, you will see that there will be the negative signs in the with the constants. So this term, the time response equation, will appear like this. So now if I sketch this one, so from 1 we are subtracting 2 exponentials, right, sum of 2 exponentials. So this will be the response of our second order system, which is overdamped. So this response is quite slow. You can see it is gradually increasing and moving towards the steady state. So an overdamped system gives you the slowest response when considering the second order system.